Commissioner Vitiello, thank you for being with us, and thanks for the meeting in my office. I enjoyed getting together and hearing about your Chicago roots and comparing a few notes. We talked about the polygraph test when you were in my office, and it was a kind of general conversation and a suggestion that the standards for the test were being changed at CBP. On Sunday in the New York Times, there was an article about one of your agents, Joel Luna. Are you familiar with his case?
I know this story.
Mr. Luna apparently was hired without a polygraph test. He was a combat veteran, served in the U.S. military, and eventually, because of his misconduct and corruption, arrested and charged with sending illegal weapons to Mexico and shipping drugs into the United States. He was convicted in January and sentenced to 20 years in prison. I want to ask you about the whole notion of changing or lowering the polygraph standards for hiring new agents into the Border Patrol. We know that the fail rate on CBP applicants taking the polygraph exam was almost twice as high as it was for other law enforcement agencies. We know that in a period of time there, 7 years after the last hiring surge, on average, almost once a week, one of the Border Patrol agents was found to be guilty of misconduct or corruption. Why would you argue, based on that, that we should lower the standards for the polygraph test for any new agents?
So the change that we're trying to make in the polygraph exam, the one that we instituted on May 1st, is a change for efficiency. We're very disappointed by the actions of former Agent Luna. Those of us that wear the badge do not like to see it tarnished in the way that he did. But there are other steps in the hiring process. We moved to a certified test under the rules in government. There's one place where you can get certified polygraphers, and there are in fact two tests that qualify for use under the law. And so we're moving from the larger, longer test to one that's more focused, that includes criminal activity and drug use, which is really the reason most people fail the polygraph now. So
I want to make sure I clarify that, because there's a conflict with the notes that I have here. According to James Tomczyk, who formerly headed your agency's internal affairs division, he's criticized this new test, and he said it's designed for civilian analysts, not law enforcement officers, and eliminates questions about drug use and document forgery. So you just said the opposite. I want to make sure it's clear on the record. Is it true that the new test does not include questions about criminal activity like drug use and document forgery?
It does include. We've asked the college, the Credibility Assessment Center, the college that certifies our polygraphers and certifies our testing and audits it. We've asked them to modify that test, which is a shorter test, has fewer series, but then it's modified to look at prior criminal activity and drug use. So it has been adjusted in a way that...
When did that adjustment take place?
Before we instituted in May. We've been working with them for several months.
A Homeland Security Advisory Panel, co-chaired, as I mentioned earlier, by Bill Bratton and DEA Administrator Karen Tandy, recommended expanding the polygraph test program to include post-employment random and targeted polygraphs, which the FBI, DIA, CIA, and NSA already do. The GAO made a similar recommendation 5 years ago. What is the position of the agency about these post-employment polygraph tests?
So we've taken all the recommendations into account that that Mrs. Tandy and Mr. Bratton gave to us, and CBP has already implemented the ones that we think make the most sense. Incumbent polygraph testing is a notion inside of CBP, but in the state that our current program is in, I can't see as a leader in the organization asking it to do more until we get the efficiency of the hiring and the right test for our entry-level employees.
Well, I'm not sure I follow what you tell me. I want to make sure it's clear on the record. So when it comes to random polygraph tests of your agents after they are hired, you're saying that you're not in a position now to do that?
Well, the program's not in a position now, and I wouldn't recommend it to the leadership in DHS to expand the program that we have now.
Are you troubled by the fact that the other major law enforcement agencies of our government already do exactly that? the FBI, the DIA, the CIA, and NSA?
I'm not sure how expansive their program is for incumbent employees.
But you would be opposed.
I wouldn't be opposed. I would be opposed to expanding the program until it works better than it does now.
Well, my time is up, and I'm going to yield. But I will tell you, hiring 5,000 new agents with anything other than a solid polygraph test that goes into their backgrounds to avoid some of the problems of the past, and saying at this point that you cannot, will not implement post-employment polygraph tests suggests to me that you're lowering some standards when it comes to law enforcement, and I don't think we should do that. I think we ought to maintain the standards across our federal government, and you're asking for an exception for your agency.
So the Secretary has been very clear, supported by the Commissioner and myself, that we won't lower standards to meet this 5,000 goal of hiring. So we think that a more efficient test is appropriate, and it is not the only thing that people have to do before they come into CBP. There's a full-scope background on every employee, and every 5 years as a government employee, you get a full-scope background investigation. So there are other steps that monitor employee conduct and their life outside of the job. And you have to remember that Border Patrol agents in a place like where I used to work in Nogales, there's 700 agents there. And so they are side by side with their colleagues. And a lot of the misconduct and the reports and some of these cases, maybe not the Luna case, but cases like that, are reported by other employees and their supervisors. So it isn't just the polygraph is the gateway into CBP. It's a full-scope background investigation that looks at people's lives going back 30 years. And then as employees, they're supervised actively in the job, and they're seen, our employees report more misconduct than any other single reporting entity. So it isn't just the polygraph exam. It's a combination of things that keeps the workforce up to speed, if you will, the way we want them to be.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm going to try to ask two questions, and one we've already spoken of, but I want to return to it because it troubles me. If you ask me as an attorney whether I believe in polygraph tests, I'll have to tell you I'm dubious. I'm skeptical. But throughout my career as an attorney, I found law enforcement believed in it, trusted it, used it over and over again. Law enforcement agencies did. And so what we have now is the belief by law enforcement agencies of the United States of America that giving someone a lie detector test when they apply for a job is a good way of determining whether they're telling the truth. And so that is what has happened over many years. It applied to your agency, FBI, Secret Service, all of them used lie detector tests. The problem we have here is that the results of the tests were terrible for your agency. The fail rate, the lie rate on the lie detector test was twice as high in your agency as the other law enforcement agencies, 65% versus 35%. So the obvious question is, what's wrong with this? Do we have that many people applying for jobs with Customs and Border Patrol who are lying to us about their backgrounds? What can we do about it? So three things have been proposed, and we've heard them here today. One of the things that's been proposed is we need to change the test. If our people are failing twice as often as people in other agencies, we can't keep taking the same test they're taking. Our people are failing it. So we need to change the test. The second thing that was proposed is we need to polygraph fewer people. My friend, Senator Flake from Arizona, said, let's not ask questions of so many people who are applying jobs for jobs at CBP. And the third proposal is, let's get rid of this test because it's nothing but an embarrassment to CBP. Do you understand my concern with those three answers to the challenge of why twice as many of the applicants for your agency fail this test as the other law enforcement agencies? That you propose change the test, change the questions, ask fewer people, or maybe get rid of the test. That seems to leave your agency vulnerable to even more corruption and misconduct. I listen to my friend from North Carolina here. I cannot imagine the environment that many of your agents work in with all of the drug cartels on the other side of the border and all of the money and guns going back and forth. It is a lethal environment. Thank you for risking your life for America to serve in it. But the temptation, obviously, is too much for some of the agents, historically. So respond to this. Tell me one more time why you think changing the test is the answer when twice as many people fail.
Well, first let me say that no one in CBP is proposing to get rid of it. We do feel like the authorization we have for waivers now is appropriate. There are other steps around those waivers, right? There's a background investigation, and the agency has to agree that that individual now in the military who holds a significant clearance has probably already passed a federal polygraph.
Mr. Luna was in the military.
But he didn't have a public trust position, and he didn't have a significantly high security clearance.
Look what he did.
The people who are eligible for waivers now would be in that category.
This man did some pretty awful things.
It's terrible. We don't want people like that in the organization.
The biggest clue to finding him was finding a headless body in a lake. This was not just stealing money under the table.
It's a terrible case. We're embarrassed he was in the organization. I've been in the Border Patrol for a long time. We wanted a polygraph for most of the time I've had this career. But we built, based on the legislation, we built a program that's not helping us hire people when we need to hire them. I think if you compare us to other agencies, you're talking about a different demographic. We can do a couple of other things, recruit more targeted recruitment in locations where we're likely to find people who will pass. I think people are confused when they come to a law enforcement agency that essentially does shift work, that has lots of people out and does lots of work that's not similar to what the FBI and
DEA does. Chief, let me ask you this question. Let's assume I've got something in my background that I think is problematic in terms of whether I can get a job in law enforcement. Now I take a look at the various federal jobs available. I'm not going to the FBI. They got a polygraph test. Ooh, I'm not going to go to the DEA. Polygraph test. Not going to go to the Secret Service. Customs and Border Patrol. No polygraph. Let me give that a try.
Well, by law,
aren't
we do.
Are you worried about that?
No, because by law, we do have a polygraph. Every law enforcement officer in CBP is required to pass a polygraph unless they can get away.
A diluted, thinned-down polygraph test.
No, it's a change in the test to make it more efficient.
I don't know what you mean by efficiency. If efficiency means people who marginally would have failed before are now going to pass, that is not efficient. That is bothersome.
Efficient is that the examiners can give more than one test in a day instead of one test that lasts 7 or 8 hours. Mm. So we think that's an appropriate risk-based approach. We think it'll work for us in CBP. And obviously, it is not the only thing that allows people to come into the agency.
I'll conclude by saying this. We either get rid of all the polygraph tests and accept your premise. It just isn't reliable. The fact that twice as many don't pass it in your agency is just the fault of the polygraph test. I don't think that's logical.
We built a program that doesn't help us hire people. We have people coming to us who believe that they shouldn't admit to their previous drug use. They're getting tripped up on this test. So we can do a better job at messaging during the recruitment process, and we can have a test that's more efficient so that our examiners can do more tests than one per day.
Thank you.